Let's focus in on the quarterbacks. In fact, I've been so inspired, I've written a poem for each one. Yeah? Can I deliver it?
No.
I'm going to ignore you because I think you'll like it. If you want Tom Brady to full effect, the answer is you must protect.
I like it. That's spot on.
It doesn't matter what you think. Let's look at Brady because... And I know you like to focus in on the power of the pocket. This is where he loves to operate, Jace.
Because you have to protect Tom Brady. This is where he needs to be, and he flourishes when you have him protected. And as you let this play out right here, he's going to throw the ball to one of his main targets, Chris Godwin, deep in the middle. And the reason he's able to do this is he feels the protection. Godwin goes up and makes a tremendous play, but once again, Brady feels the trust from his O-line, and he's able to execute that.
And here's another example, again against the Packers in that championship game from 2 weeks ago.
And once again, what is he going to do? He's going to throw the ball down the field vertically because he's protected to his speed receiver, Scotty Miller, right down the sideline for a touchdown. If you protect Tom Brady, he can make it happen. Now, right here, you're going to see because of the protection, he's able to read the defense. I want you to select the safety right there, number 26. Yes. Now, you're going to have a double in route by these receivers. Show me a double in, Dan.
Okay, I'll try and get this right. So, sort of in here and
yep.
This way.
That's it, Dan.
Oh, look at this.
Dan.
I know you're enjoying that, boys.
You're spot on. Now, this safety's going to have to choose which one of these routes to take. Tom Brady's going to see it. Why? Because he is protected. Let's see it play out. You have the double in route, and you have the catch by number 18, Tyler Johnson, because Tom Brady felt nice and cozy in that pocket. Now, I want you to set Gronkowski down here.
Okay, down here.
They use Gronkowski in pass protection a lot. So what do you do when you do that? You run the screen because people think he is pass blocking, and he sneaks out there on a screen pass. Brilliant play design by them, and they pick up a lot of yardage. You're going to see plays like this in the game to change things up for the defense. Gronk makes you pay every time. And for all of this to work, once again, he's protected. He takes another shot down the field to his main target, Mike Evans. He wants to get him the ball vertically at all times. And for all of this to work, you're going to have to establish the running game. Leonard Fournette's going to have a great game, especially on first and second down, because they want to set up the play action pass on the back of that. The running game is going to be key and essential for their success.
I know you've not asked for a circle here, but this is one of my favourite images. Poor old Kevin King there. That is death by pylon, isn't it?
Night-night.
So that's a really clear indication of what the Bucs need to get right. The Mahomes poem, yeah?
Bring it to us.
If Patrick is to
find...
I don't really know.
Shoulder shimmy?
That's called the poetry shimmy, that one. If Patrick is to find his groove, you'll always see him on the move.
Ooh. He wants to move.
Are you buying into this?
I love it. He's on it. He's actually on top of everything.
Here,
it's all about the movement from Patrick Mahomes. Let it run and let's show you what his fancy feet can do. Right here, Patrick Mahomes on the move. He has someone coming at him free and clear, but his movement allows this play to create. He gets the ball to Tyreek Hill, his speed receiver in space. That's all because of Patrick Mahomes' movement. Once again, he drops back. He has some pressure on him, so he spins out of it with his movement to the left. Throws the ball to Travis Kelce on an out down the sideline. Once again, his movement. Now, check this out. I want you to pause this. I want you to select number 24, the safety for the Raiders. Now, this, I've been in this position before. This is what the threat of Patrick Mahomes does. As you see it play out, his movement is going to make the safety vacate his zone, his area. And as soon as he comes up, what does Patrick Mahomes do? Throws it right behind his ear to Travis Kelce. Touchdown. That was a game winner. Once again, his movement. Pressure in his face, a delayed blitz. He throws the ball down the sideline, one-on-one coverage to Tyreek Hill, who can outrun everyone.
Not me, Jason.
And down here in the red zone, he boots out to the left and finds his receiver, Sammy Watkins, who's a big target and a physical guy, so he likes to get him the ball down by the red zone. Once again, pressure everywhere. What does he do? He creates with his feet, with the movement. He extends the play. Who does he find again? Oh, it's Sammy Watkins in the end zone, and he's going to let them know, I'm your target. And you know what this guy can do? He can play in any weather. It doesn't matter. He hits McCole Hardman on a deep crosser. Once again, his movement creates all of these plays. Now, all that movement, what does he have to have the threat of? The ability to run. He needs to make you pay, Dan, and especially on third and long where he can pick up those valuable yards and get first down. He's going to have to do this all game to have any success in the Super Bowl.
That's really fascinating, isn't it? Because what it shows you is we're building up to the Super Bowl, the game, and you've got two quarterbacks who've got their teams there, and their styles, OC, are just so completely different.
Absolutely love it, man. You have Patrick Mahomes, like Jason just showed you, doing all that pocket movement, and then you got Tom Brady with the old man game. He's just sliding in there, man, getting things done. I absolutely love it.
How come you're allowed to do that, but I'm not?
Because I got, it's the, you know, it's, right, the, it's okay, the black thing.
Okay, I can't do that.